Hi everyone, this is Ami Diamond from SharePoint Wizard. I would like to share with you the new experience of creating a list from SharePoint and from Microsoft List. So I'm now in the team site, I will click on the new, and now I have two possibilities. I have a list and a list form. So let's choose list form because that's new. So once I get here, I will be shown preview of what a form is. It's actually the new form. I need to give a name. Let's give it name form 12. And directly, instead of creating a list, it will automatically create the list and a form where I can directly start adding columns. So you see it automatically redirected. Here I can add another all kinds of columns. Let's call this status, and we could put some choices, but you probably know all about it. So, and of course a name. So now let's see what else can we create in this menu. So we saw that the list form brings us automatically to the list, to the form. If we choose list, we see a new page which is designed modernly, and we can see all kinds of types of blank lists that we can create. We can create a custom list, a form, a gallery, that's the view, the calendar, and the board. In addition, we can import from Excel, from CSV, an existing list. And we can use the templates either of Microsoft or from your organization in case you have created such things. So let's see what happens. We click the list, and actually we can directly say if the user doesn't know anything about Microsoft List or SharePoint List, he can say, I need a gallery. So I'll create this. Let's call it gallery. And what it will do, it will create a list, and automatically the default will be actually the view. So you see it's a gallery, and actually what we can do here, if he wants, he can of course edit the current view, and he can, in addition, he can go back, he can also format this view. So as you can see, he can go to edit the thing, and he can actually decide what to show, what not to show. Obviously he needs to add some columns in order, for instance, an image, that it will be possible to present it. But directly it's possible to create it with this view. Let's go back. Let's see what else can we do. So we'll choose list, and this time we will say, let's say the user wants to make a board. So he chooses it. He sees a display on how it should look. So let's call this, in this name, and this is supposed to create a list with a board view. So you see it's automatically a board view. Of course you can create the view from here, yeah? But now automatically he even creates two items, and it's possible to create buckets. So let's call it new, if it's a status, and we could do this old. And now he can actually take the item and drag it from one to each other. He can always come here and change it, as you can see here. Let's go and see what else it can do. So this time we will choose a calendar. So here is a preview of how it will look. Let's call it calendar. Let me see. And now it will actually create a list with the calendar view. And you can see this is a weekly one, but he automatically can enter some information here, and now he can adjust it as he wants. So we did a thing here. If he wants, he can change it, let's say, to be monthly, and he could also save it and even format it to save, to have conditional formatting. But this time, this is what enables actually the user that doesn't have much information as a quick starting point to create it. We saw the create the gallery, the calendar, the board, and the form is actually creating a form just like we did. So this will be form 000, and it automatically is creating the list and the form that he can start and share. So this is a new interface that you can do it. As we saw, we can also either create it from the list or from the list forms. Let's just see if the experience is the same from the Microsoft list. I'll go to the nine dots and choose Microsoft list. And hopefully it will load. And I will click new list. And here, let's see. Yes, we have this new interface.